Thanks for joining us for the daily update. First things first, there are 7,405 cases of coronavirus in Victoria. That is 300 new cases since we last updated you. 51 of those are connected to known and contained outbreaks. 249 of those are under investigation by our public health team. There are 206 Victorians in hospital. 41 of those are receiving intensive care. I am saddened to have to report that there have been a further 6 deaths as a result of this virus since we last updated you. That takes the total number of Victorians who have died because of coronavirus to 55. We'll try and provide further information as we can, but each of those are connected to an aged care setting. 3 of those individuals, I'm not quite certain on gender in terms of the notes I have, but if we can update you, we will. 3 in their 90s and 3 in their 80s. If we can update you with any further information, of course we will. In the meantime though, we send our best wishes, our condolences, our thoughts and our prayers to the families of those 6 individuals. This will be a particularly challenging and difficult time, a very sad time for them. And I hope that there is some small measure of comfort knowing that our support and our condolences are extended to them. 24,118 tests yesterday, still a very impressive number. That's sticking around that mid-20,000s number and sometimes higher each and every day. We're very, very grateful to everybody who's coming forward to get tested. Apart from a tiny number of people, each of those have symptoms. They're doing the right thing, acting on those symptoms, coming forward, getting tested. And then, of course, they need to then isolate while they wait for their result. We're pushing as hard as we can. We're using additional laboratory capacity from around the country, from the private sector as well, to get those results as quickly as we can. But getting tested is a very powerful thing to do. It's a very big contribution to our fight against this wicked enemy. But then staying at home while you wait for your results, that's really important as well. And we're grateful to people who are doing just that. There are 3,734 active cases across the state. I don't have a metro regional breakdown, but we'll provide that and other details on outbreaks and other matters when we get to the Chief Health Officer's release at the usual time around 1:30, 2 o'clock as per usual. And now, I'll leave it to the Prime Minister to update on National Cabinet. I've just come from a National Cabinet meeting. But what I wanted to discuss today is part of our unique partnership with the Australian Defence Force, a long-standing partnership, one that has seen until last couple of weeks about 350 members of the ADF on the ground. That's been bolstered. It's now in excess of 1,400, and we're very grateful to all of those staff. In my discussions with Commodore Hill and others, they are absolutely doing fantastic work for us. They're well and truly integrated to both enable, assist and advise, and it's a really important contribution. There are many others as well, whether it be from other Victorian government agencies Commonwealth public servants that are playing an equally important part. But I wanted to focus on one particular issue today where we are deploying ADF personnel in an innovative and a unique way. So today's case is 300 cases. Each of those people, attempts will be made to contact those within the next 24 hours. Many of them will be contacted much, much sooner than that, but the aim is to have every single one of them contacted within 24 hours. That's not always possible, principally because some people won't answer the phone, some people, may answer the phone but are not particularly interested in making a time to sit down and go through that rather that longer process to be interviewed about all their close contacts. That's about the number of people that we can't contact. And again, we're not making judgments about those people. In the main, it'll just be playing phone tag, if you like, back and forth, but not actually connecting with those people. That can be up to about 25%. It is unacceptable that we have anybody not contacted within that 24-hour period. And when I say contacted, not just a phone call outbound, but an actual interview conducted. What we're going to do, and this has happened the last 3 or 4 days to be proven up, when it's now going to be dramatically expanded, there'll be some 28 teams of ADF personnel and authorised officers from the Department of Health. They will go out in the following circumstances. So one of those...
That is where we'll leave Victoria's Premier Daniel Andrews speaking. So 300 confirmed cases in Victoria overnight. That's about 100 down from yesterday. Tragically, six new deaths recorded, three people in their 90s, three in their 80s, and tragically, all in aged care homes.